Okay, let's do some math for fun. Here we have two derivative questions on the spot. The first one is the derivative of x to the third power. And the second one, it seems like this street is at a very unusual place. This is meant to be at the top left corner. So what exactly does this mean? And in fact, this is meant to be a post-Calc 1 video because I just finished my summer Calculus 1 class about 3 days ago. So I want to do this for my students because I didn't have a chance to show them this right here. But anyway, without further ado, we know that this right here should be the easier one, so let's just finish this. The derivative of x to the third power is, of course, 3x squared. And if I put like 20 of these questions on the final exams, then my students will be going crazy because, well, yeah, I'll be like the best teacher ever. Anyway, if you want to show work, you can bring this 3 to the front and then minus 1. That's kind of cute, yeah? And for this one, can we just maybe bring the 3 back and maybe add 1 or subtract 1? Well, I don't know. In fact, no. Not at all. Right? So let me now do it legitimately. So I will make some note on the side for you guys. The first note is, of course, the good old exponential notation. X to the third power, when we have this 3 right here at the top left corner, this means that we should write down this how many times, right? 3 times. So I will just put down x, and then we multiply them together. So it's x times x times x. That's it. And if you have a 3 at the top left corner instead, and then x, this 3 is telling us that we still write down the x 3 times, but we are going to build them up as powers. In other words, this is the same as saying x raised to the x raised to the x power, like that. And remember, whenever we have a power to a power to a power, when there is no parentheses, it's meant to be that we do this to that power first and use that as a result and then do x to that power. Well, I will indicate a little parenthesis to just emphasize that, but you know, without the parentheses, it's meant to be like that. So in order for us to differentiate that, we will actually have to differentiate x to the x to the x power. So that's pretty much it. So let's go ahead and do that. Let's see how this is going to go. 3 and then the x. And by the way, just for fun, this right here also has a different notation. I can also write this down as x with a double arrow, double up arrow. And then you can put down a 3 right there. And in fact, when you have x to the third power like this, you could have write this down as x with an up arrow one time only, 3. So that's a really nice connection. And this right here is just called the up arrow notation. So it depends on if you like the up arrow notation or if you like the left exponent notation or weird exponent notation, up to you. Yeah. So I'm going to put this down in the thumbnail just to make a little clickbait. Anyway, we're pretty much just going to differentiate this, which is pretty much just that. There we go. We see that dx, I will look at this as x to the x to the x. And the deal is that when you have a function base, that's no good. We want to have the base being the constant e. So the usual trick is that we look at this base and then try to rewrite it. Well, we know I can write x as e for the base, but I just have to raise that to the ln x power because e and ln cancel each other out. So now I can write this as dx, and that's pretty much the same as e to the ln x power, and then we raise this to the x power like that. And now you see, this is x to the x power, so I can, you know, this is a power, and then this is e to a power. We can multiply the powers. So I will just do this times that, and let me put that in the front first. So this is the same as a dx, and I will have the base e. I'm multiplying this and that, so let me write down x to the x, and then we will have the ln x right here. And now we are kind of ready to integrate, to differentiate. I don't know how to integrate this, guys, so don't ask me in the comment section. Anyway, we can actually differentiate e to the something. Well, it's always the same thing, so let's write it down. I'll just write it as e to the x times ln x, like this. And then the chain rule says I will have to multiplied by the derivative of the inside. This is not that bad because I can just keep the first function, namely x to the x power times the derivative of the second, and the derivative of ln x is 1 over x. And then we continue by adding the second function, which is ln x, and let me close that because the x is the only thing that's meant to be in the ln. And now the difficult part comes. We will have to multiply by the derivative of x to the x. And what is the derivative of x to the x? And yes, you are right. We are pretty much going to do this again. And let me just do this on the side. Yeah. Okay, so I will put this down, dx, and then I need to get x to the x. Right? So this is just another note. And to differentiate this, yes, we are going to look at the base x as that again. So we see that this is nothing but just the same as differentiating e to the ln x and then raised to the x power. And similarly, we can just pretty much multiply by x right here. So I'll multiply this x with the ln x right here, which is similar to what we did right here. Okay, and then we pretty much do the same thing. The derivative of e to something is once again that thing, so it's e to the x times ln x. And guess what? We have to use the chain rule again. So I will multiply by the derivative of this. This is not bad. The derivative of this is we first keep x and times the derivative second, which is 1 of x, and then we add it with the second function, which is ln x, and then we multiply by the derivative of the first, which is just 1. So all in all, this is, I will change this back to x to the x, right? E to the x times ln x is pretty much the original, so this is x to the x. And then we can see this is just 1 and then plus ln x like that. So when we need to multiply by the derivative of x to the x, it's pretty much this right here. I will just enter this part right here. X to the x times 1 plus ln x like this, okay? So this is the derivative of x to the x part. So that's it. And we're pretty much done. Perhaps some people would like me to kind of simplify it. And I think I will. And let's do the following. First of all, if you look at the inside, this is one term. And you add it with the other. And both terms, they do have the x to the x. So I will bring that to the front. Okay, I'll factor that out right here. And if you look at e to the x times ln x, this right here, if you trace back, is just x to the x to the x. And later, I'm going to write it down as this notation just for fun. But anyway, I will first write this down as x to the x to the x. Yeah? And now the inside, I will have 1 over x, and I add it with ln x times this times that. It depends if you want to distribute or not. I think I will, so let me do that. Ln x times 1, of course, ln x, close that. And then this times this is ln x, and you square that. So you can put down as ln x. You can put down the square right here. That's actually legitimate, but I think I will just be super clear and then put down the square right here. And with that, we are all done. And if you would like, you can write it down as this kind of notation for this. If you want to do that, this one is 2x. And then this is like 3x like that. The backwards exponent, though. Okay? I don't know the proper way to say this, but anyway, 1 over x plus ln x plus parentheses ln x, and then you square that. And in fact, you don't need this parentheses because there's only one thing inside of the x. Yeah. And if you would like, you can also use the up arrow notation. So for this one in red, how should we write it? Well, this means x to the x power. And if you look back, when you have 3 and an x right here, you pretty much do x to the up arrow twice and then that, right? So this right here is x double up arrow. I haven't made any error yet. So x double up, arrows. Ah! And then multiply by this, which is x, arrow, and then 3. and then multiply by the rest. 1 over x plus ln x plus ln x square. Okay, depending on which one you like, I will just bug everybody for you guys like this. So, yeah. Anyway, hopefully you guys find this being cool. And of course, you might be wondering, well, as we all know, the good old power rule, x to the nth power, this is just n times x to the n minus 1, bring the power to the front minus 1. Easy. Well, is there any nice rule for the derivative if the n is right here, x? Well, you know where's the best place to find answers to like math questions? YouTube comment section. So I'm going to leave this to you guys. So maybe you want to contribute and answer whatever you want to answer over there. Anyway, hopefully you guys all like this video. And for my students who are watching, we have 1 week vacation. So enjoy your vacation. Anyway, this is it.